17 verse, 2 Chronicles 7 and 17. When we have it, we say amen.
Amen.
The word of God even reads, it says, as for you, if you walk before me as your father David walked, and do according to all that I have commanded you, and if you keep my statutes and my judgment, then I will establish the throne of your kingdom. Y'all hear that? I will establish the throne of your kingdom as I covenant with David, your father, saying you shall not fail to have a man. Did y'all catch that? A man as ruler in Israel. I just want to talk from your thing tonight. I want to talk about a man of God. Right. Somebody look at the neighbor real quick. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
We're talking tonight.
We're talking tonight.
About a man.
About a man.
God. Talk about a man of God. There's something significantly different about a man who really loves God. It's just the difference in where you are, your attitude, your thought process, your actions, your ways, the way you carry yourself. How many of y'all know it's the difference between a man of the world and a man of God? You don't even convene or to have fellowship with someone without mentioning the name of God. It's just the difference. It's just the difference, the way you carry yourself. You don't have to chat after the world. How many of y'all know the world should be chatting after God? So it ought to be a difference between the pimp and the preacher. Y'all know they can preach for a few moments. There's a certain integrity that you have, standard of your life. That's why I say everybody that love God ought to have some growth in your life. You shouldn't be 30 years into this thing and still be the same immature person that you once was in the world. I wish somebody to tap 3 folks and tell them, look, everybody make mistakes. Just because you're a man of God does not mean you're a perfect man. I know I'm saying amen is on that. I said, just because you're a man of God does not mean you're a perfect man. Because we all make mistakes. And I think a lot of times we have put folks on such a high pedestal and we have put them on a high standard until they're not even able to reach. Some folks have their pastors in such a high level until without any mistake they make. They always want to grow and say something of a reason why I don't come to church. I wish somebody to tap a neighbor and say, even in the pulpit, it got to be some integrity. But it ought to be some integrity in the pews. And so I'm not talking about a perfect man, but I'm talking about a man of God. Because if we read the word, we'll find out that every man that stood up for God has made some kind of mistake. Unless his name was Jesus Christ. All have sinned, have fallen short. Just to tell you that there ought to be a difference. There ought to be a certain way about you. There ought to be a level of integrity. There ought to be a something of God that's inside of you that convicts you and have you stand up to be the man that you need to be. Thank you, Jesus. I'm talking about a man of God that loves God, that walk after God, that does not mind sharing what God has given them. I think it's mighty bad where you have to always prove that you're a man. If I gotta always come home and tell my wife I'm a man, there's something wrong with my manhood. Thank you, Holy Ghost. about. Got to remind somebody, I'm a man. I'm a real man. You know what? I ain't got to remind nobody who I am. If I live my title, I don't have to raise my voice. Help somebody. I don't have to go around telling everybody that I'm a man of God if I just live for God. Does anybody in the room know about if you let your light shine before men? You don't have to tell everybody that you saved and sanctified. Just live the life. I watch them folk always hollering, tap my old time, always hollering, praise the Lord, always talking about God this and God that. Why don't you live the life? How many of y'all know your life is in you, will shine? About you, your approach, your ways, because you know what? A child of God got no business in foolish conversation.
Yes.
Just because everybody else cussing, you ain't got the cuss. Just because everybody else drinking, you ain't got the drink. Just because they smoking weed, you ain't got the smoke weed. God. I appreciate y'all, sisters, but tonight we're talking about a man. Amen. How God uses the man of God. Because the word of God, I got about a few more minutes, I'm getting out of here. But in the book of Genesis, the word said that God created the heavens and the earth. When God got through and he had formed the earth, he saw how beautiful everything was. And God said, what's the purpose of having all this? And nobody to enjoy. Well, said God took the dead from the ground. God did some artwork. It was God before it was Michelangelo. God is the great artist. Well, said he didn't even need a mirror. I wish I had me somebody. Just about all of those artists, they need something to look at. They need a model. They need to look in a mirror. God didn't need a mirror. The word said he took dirt and he made a sad dog can't wag his tail sometimes. God made me who I am. Word said that when he created